That was not cool.
I have him in this.
Hello everyone! Oh my gosh, it's been absolutely ages since I've done a video, and I say this all the time and I should do videos more often, but I'm really sorry. It's crazy because I don't actually know what hairs I'm gonna do yet. I'm gonna just go with the flow. I'm gonna show you my signature bun, but first I'm gonna start off by taking off these curl formers. I've done a video before of like how I do my curl formers and stuff, but yeah, I might fast forward this part. How's everyone been? How's your hair journeys going? What's your favourite products? What's your favourite protective styles? Really love you to answer all in the comments below, because it's always interesting to know what people's faves are. Mine are really simple. I just do like a low bun. I mean, that's my main signature protective style. Just low bun, red lipstick. You probably always see me have. And always, pretty much always, my mini ears. Animated cartoon. But yeah. Super shiny. I hope you can see that. Curl formers are so cool because you don't have to use heat. Like, I pretty much haven't used heat on my hair for, like, basically since I started my hair journey, because thankfully I found out about curl formers quite early into my journey, thanks to Natural85. I love her. She's my big sis. My internet big sis. And, yeah, so I haven't really, anytime I wanted to stretch my hair, I would literally just curl form it, and so I've literally never really used heat on my hair. I don't know if you guys have seen my sunflower picture of my hair shrinkage. I have a feeling my hair shrinks that much, and because it's basically really elastic, and maybe the fact that I don't use heat is one of the main reasons why it is elastic. As always, what I do next is separate it all. Let's start from the beginning. Some people put some oil on their hands and stuff, but my hair's still got a tiny bit of oil on, so I'm not gonna bother. Ouch, my nails go really far. I've been meaning to, it's not focusing, is it? Why not? Why is it not focusing? No! How? Hope so. Can't see. Anyway, back to separating. The key thing about curl formers is making sure it dries, and because I air dry my hair, I have to think in advance. So apparently it takes about 6 hours to dry by air drying, but I'd say if possible to keep it for longer, then definitely do so, because like for example my hair is quite thick and long, so I think it takes a bit longer than I've noticed over the years it takes longer anyway. So I'd say just do it overnight, like do it like a, maybe like 9 the night before, and when you wake up just take them off. We could do it during the day if you don't mind the feeling. It's something you have to get used to. It might feel uncomfortable if it's like your first time sort of using that.
Yeah, I'm so happy with your natural hair video. I feel bad, but I wish I'd done more. I'm definitely gonna try and do more and more. And just separating. This is what it looks like. I hope this is focusing. Better be. So, I could be naughty and separate it more, as in frizz it out like I always do. I could just keep it. What should I do? Comment below. It'll be too late by then. What I normally do is literally frizz it out completely. Decisions. So this is pretty much how much I'm going to frizz it out today. Normally I literally just go crazy and frizz it out completely, but today I'll leave it at here. So here's I'm really hoping this is focusing on my hair. I don't think it is. Okay, so what style am I going to do for you? Ooh, good question. So I know it's a bit cheeky, but I decided to just frizz out my hair, like, because I just can't deal. This is what I always do, and I'm just so used to it. So I'm just going to frizz it out completely. Literally, every single curl, I'm going to frizz out. I doesn't take too long. I just literally need to frizz out everything. So I might pause and then restart, or I could just fast forward. But literally, there is no technique. Just taking every curl and taking it out, frizzing it out. Oh gosh. Yeah, it takes a while sometimes, but it is possible. Like, you're probably saying these people saying, be careful with your curls, handle it carefully. My memory ran out a bit, but keep on going. I'm gonna keep on going and going and going until I am satisfied. But yeah, as I mentioned in my videos, in my first video, I haven't combed my hair for 4 years now. That video was nearly 2 years ago, and so my memory ran out. So you can see my hair's gone a bit bigger, loads more frizzier. And that brings me to the point of this video and my ultimate tip for the summer. When it comes down to it, people tend to become obsessed with the perfection of natural hair, I guess. But it's the imperfections that make everyone different, and that makes it so unique and so cool. What I wanted to tell you is that in this upcoming summer, 2015, you're probably going to do your hair like how my hair was earlier, curly, super curled, really shiny, and then it'll literally probably take 2 hours, and then the humidity will make your hair either shrink, frizz up, just basically the opposite to what you intended. So what I wanted to say is that you need to learn to accept your hair in all different facets, whether it shrinks or whether it frizzes up, because it will happen, and if you accept it, you're not going to beat yourself up about it. Frizz tends to be affiliated with dryness, but what if the frizz was self-initiated and you just learn to accept yourself and your hair as you are? Because it's so important to realise that, because at the end of the day, your hair will frizz up in the summer and it will shrink. But as I've shown you in this video, it's okay. It's absolutely fine. Like, obviously there are ways to prevent and reduce frizz, blah blah blah, but at the end of the day, you need to learn to accept it. So if it does happen in the summer and you've done your hair, you've planned it a week before, you've done it and prepared for it the night before, but it comes down to it and it literally reverts within 2 hours, then you need to go to the mirror and say to yourself, okay, this is what's happened. My hair's gone all frizzy. What can you do? I mean, of course you can go and bring out your tools and start fixing it, but you can also just accept it. And yeah, there are also styles you can do to sort of just maintain it and sort of prevent it from frizzing more and etc. That's all cool, but whatever happens, just learn to accept that your hair will frizz, it will shrink in some, and it's absolutely okay. See, I've demonstrated it in the video. I did my hair, I planned my hair the night before. I had to
basically dry it for about 8 hours, like air dried it in curl formers, just to show you this and just to prove that it's absolutely okay. You know, like, some people are just not used to seeing their hair in certain ways, and so when it does happen, they're like, oh my gosh, I hate this, what should I do, oh my gosh, what, it doesn't look like that YouTuber, it doesn't look like that blogger, it doesn't look like this. It's okay, everyone's hair is different and no one's hair is perfect. If everyone's hair was perfect, that'd be boring. So that's what I want to tell you in this video. That is okay, it's absolutely fine. And now that I've given you advice for summer, I'm going to give you a quick tip for if there are times when you really, really, really need to tame your hair after it's gone a bit frizzy or shrunken. Hopefully I can do it in less than 1 minute. So simply all you do is just gonna smooth it down on both sides, but you can start off with one. Smooth it down, smooth it down, smooth it down. And then you don't need a hairband for this, you don't need any bobby pins, you don't need any moisturizer, you don't need anything. So it's like this. Simply gonna start twisting around like this on it, upon itself. And then on top of that, you're gonna go round again. So it's like a ballerina bun, but the beautiful version. So yeah, just really, really, really quick. Really, really, really quick. Like, it will take you hopefully less than a minute, but 2 minutes max. Okay, all around itself. You can spend more time on it to make it perfect if you want, but this is it. So done. There we go. Simple. So this is the cute little miniature buns. It's easy to do big buns too, but big buns don't really help to retain moisture. I do a whole separate video on that. But as you can see, no hairbands used, no bobby pins used. It'll keep your hair intact until you're ready to do whatever you want to do. But yeah, thank you so, 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 so much for watching this video. I hope you understood the message I was trying to send through, and hopefully you'll have a happy hair journey throughout the summer, because you know you're just going to learn to accept yourself and accept your hair, because you are beautiful and I love you. So thank you so, so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Leave comments below on what video you want to see next.